But first, give it up for the boys whose X-rated exploits have put the band into boy band. It's McFly! I didn't know you were going to wear that.
We look like we work at EasyJet.
You do?
We got some EasyJet fans.
Hold on to your handbags and wallets. What would you like to drink, loves?
What have we got?
Well, we got so two of you don't drink, do you?
Yeah.
Who don't drink? What we got here? Capri Sun. What do you like, my love?
What have you got?
Sambuca. Margarita. Who likes a margarita? Margarita. And you've just got back from your tour of Brazil and America.
Yeah, Brazil a couple of weeks ago.
What was it like? Oh, no, that's not what you want. Sorry.
It was amazing.
I am listening. I just got to.
No, it was incredible. Brazil's amazing. Really, it's really incredible.
It's mad out there. The fans are crazy. It literally, they make you feel like you're Justin Bieber or like you're in, honestly, seriously, they're just so crazy.
What, 12?
Yeah. they're so passionate and it's nice for us.
It was brilliant.
There
very
you
special.
Go, love. Hey, you haven't even put your straw in your Capri Sun.
Is there a straw? You didn't give us a straw.
When I was growing up, there used to be a straw sanitizer.
It's got like a nipple thing on it.
A nipple?
Yeah.
It's been so long since I've been near one, you might as well have one. We've got to talk about your book, yeah?
Yeah.
No, honestly, it's proper kiss and tell, isn't it? But you've kissed and told about yourself.
Yeah, each other.
Yeah.
Yeah, we always said we wanted to do a book. We always wanted to wait until we felt we could do our story justice and tell it as it actually is, because being in a band, you know, when you're young, there's a lot of good stories, you know, interesting stuff happens. But, you know, when we were kind of, 15 to 18, you know, you have fans who are young teenagers and you can't really, you know, say the truth of what really happens. But now we're, you know, we're older, we're men. we just felt the time was right now. We can actually tell the truth and say what happens.
Yeah, I mean, like Tom said, we thought it's time to tell our side of the story and you know, hold nothing back, really. So.
And everything's in there.
Everything's in there, yeah, absolutely.
Because I've got a checklist here of things you've got to do when you're in a band, OK?
OK.
So let's see who's done what. Who's got off with a fan? Danny.
Yeah, but yeah.
Point for every fan. How many?
Like how many bits of paper you got?
Oh, yeah. I start getting paper cuts. If it's up. Who's had a threesome?
Yeah, we have.
Have we had a threesome?
No.
No.
Yeah, we have.
The most best. Is that the one in the book?
No, I don't think that's.
Because there's a mother, daughter combo, isn't there?
Oh.
I hate that phrase, mother daughter combo. I much prefer family bucket.
This margarita style takes months.
So come on, which of you had the mother daughter combo?
That was.
How did that happen?
You know, you sat in a bar and this picture comes along from security and it's this, you know, this girl and she's outside and bring your mum in. Within 10 minutes, her mum's got a boob out.
Didn't she have a tattoo of Bon Jovi on her boob?
Quite possibly.
Tattoo of John Bon Jovi on her tit? Yeah. Didn't that freak you out, though, if she just pulled it out and there was John Bon Jovi staring at her? That would freak me out.
I don't know, he's a good-looking dude, so...
Not with a nipple as his nose, though.
OK. Who's had a MILF or a GILF? You had nothing. Dougie, GILF or a GILF?
GILF. I'll go with a GILF.
What? That's not cool anymore? I thought it was cool.
That's never been cool. Shaggy the Brand.
I thought all the kids were there.
We're trying to stay hip.
A lot of your sexploits were quite homoerotic, if you ask me. Did the love that dare not speak its name ever rear its ugly head in McFly? Have you ever, like, touched tongues or, like, you
know... Us
yeah. Well, we always what
you just touched You'd said that you touched...
I've touched both their tongues. I'm pretty sure I touched your tongue.
No. I've never touched your tongue.
Do it. Do it. What a letdown. I'm always the last to find out. Like, I found out half of these stories when we were talking about for the book.
Really?
When did that happen? Like, why? Where was I? What? Do, why didn't I? Why was I involved?
You're a bad wanking mate.
But also, if people buy the book and read it, it's not all filth. I mean, I was reading it and then last year, you were really in a bit of a bad way, weren't you? Seriously speaking, I mean, there was, like, depression and there was a bit too much drinking and stuff. How close did you come to calling it quits?
In my head, it's never been quits, really.
No, I don't think we've ever wanted to call it quits as a band, but I think individually, some of us have really, you know, hit rock bottom, and I think... You worry as to whether you can carry on doing what you're doing when you're in such a dark place.
I think especially with what we do, the highs are so high. You know, when you're having number ones and you're traveling all around the world and selling out stuff, it's amazing. But so it makes the lows in comparison really low. So that's when it's kind of tough, I think, for, you know, people in our position to kind of deal with.
And remember, Dougie, last time you were on Chatty Man, I could tell you weren't yourself, because now reading the book, you realise you had a big old battle on your hands. It got really dark, didn't it, reading it, and about you trying to kill yourself.
Yeah.
Did it feel better once you'd written it? Put it down on paper and talked about it and stuff?
I think it's always kind of good to reflect on that sort of stuff. It's quite easy to, you know, I'm in a really, really good place now, to forget about all that stuff. Yeah. So it is quite therapeutic to go back. It's quite scary, and it's a bit of an eye-opener to how dark it can get if you take your foot off the gas and stop looking after yourself.
I mean, half the time, you didn't really know what you were doing. It was often us telling you what was going on, so...
I was so battered the whole time. That's why.
I mean, the book is a roller coaster ride, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it has...
I think that's, you know, that was the point in it. I think we just... It's like Dougie said, I think honesty is just the best thing. We didn't want to do anything that kind of... you know, hid the truth or, you know, painted, you know, us in a different light. We just wanted to be honest because we're all in really good places now. You know, we've all been through ups and downs and, you know, Harry's engaged now, Dougie's sorted himself out, I'm married, Danny's the same as he's always been.
Anyway, I'm glad you're back to your normal self, Dougie, yeah? Have your Capri Sun. Cheers.
Cheers.
You got married to Giovanna early this year.
Yeah, I did.
What was that like?
It was honestly the best day of my life. Like, it was incredible.
Ah, oh, there we are. Look at that.
What magazine was it in again?
I can't remember. These three, they were my best men. You know, their speech was ridiculous.
Like, what did they say? What were they saying?
Oh, it was very crude.
Yeah, yeah. Really crude. Like, really? Dougie can get away with saying stuff that no one else... Like, if I said the stuff that he says, I'd be in prison. It's that bad. Like, I don't even want to say it. I can't even say what he said.
Come on, what is
he? He thanked my dad for ejaculating in my mum's vagina.
That's the truth, though. That's how babies are made. I'm just being honest.
My nan and granddad were sat like a meter from him when he was saying this.
Oh my
God. I don't even think that was the worst thing you said.
That wasn't the worst?
No, it was bad.
I think he then congratulated her for squeezing him out of her vagina, considering he has such a big chin.
That is... lovely having you on, boys.
Thank you.
And good luck with the book.
Thank you very much.
Give it up for McFly, everyone! Cheryl Powell and Leona Lewis will be here. See you in part two.